Episode 2959, How to Be More Attractive.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by. Happy, happy day. I hope you're having a fabulous week. It is Wellness Wednesday, and it's time to get your health on. It's time to pay priority to the inside so you can look awesome on the outside. How to be more attractive. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by AIM, Inspiring Connection and Community. Okay, take a deep breath because I know you're thinking, Christiane, what is this title? How to Be More Attractive? Seriously? Yeah, I want us to have a really serious conversation. One that might be so honest for yourself that you actually see yourself differently. So let me ask you this. Why do you allow others to project their definitions of a healthy lifestyle on yourself? If you want to live the life you desire, learn how to be more attractive by your definition and reflection. The world does not need to dictate what healthy living is all about for you. But it does, right? I mean, look at it. Look at what's in your reels. Look what is coming up on your Facebook advertisements, those that are sponsored. I mean, come on, I try to keep telling them, get out of here, get out of here. What about on just even the regular TV? All the ads. Look at the Super Bowl. All of the Super Bowl, from the ads to the entertainment, you name it. Pre-bowl, halftime bowl, post-bowl, okay? Yeah, we have an issue in our world today, in our society, that places a definition as to what is attractive. And unfortunately, if you're a woman, it is not for you whatsoever. And yes, the color of your skin plays into that. I'm just going to let it all hang out on the table today. Because unfortunately, we as women are very unfair to our bodies, which then makes us very unfair to our families, to the people we love, our spouses, our sweethearts. It makes us be someone that we're not. We dress up and we pretend. And I don't know about you, but having this masquerade ball every single moment of your life is ridiculous. You don't have to dress up and be Cinderella in everybody's eyes, but you do need to be Cinderella in your own eyes, whatever that looks like for you. Your body is your responsibility. You can learn from the science and make your decisions as to what works best for you. But ultimately, what seems to hold most of us back? You know it. It's who we see in the mirror. It's that reflection. Our reflections can be a deterrent to who we are not, what we are lacking, and where we have failed. I'm sure you've got stories on all of those counts. At the same time, our reflections can remind us of who we can become even when all we see is a mess. This is real life. You don't have to have all the answers in order to move forward on a goal. You don't have to be all in without errors to pursue a healthy lifestyle. It's about releasing the control that overrules your every step. Perfection does not equate to what you see in your reflection. Think about that for a minute. Because if you go, let's just take the Super Bowl, because most likely you saw some form of commentary if you weren't watching the game itself. You heard someone talking about it. You saw something come up on your news feed, in your social media feed. Something has crossed your eyes. And there's always somebody coming to make a comment of what people look like. And the definitions are all defined by, yes, I'm going to say it, the color of your skin, 100%. It's also, what are you doing? What is the role that you play in society? Are you a celebrity? Man, a celebrity? Ooh, you better watch that body figure of yours, right? I mean, come on. Let's get down to the real life. Because until we understand the world that we live in, the society, what is around us, how can we be a change? How can we make a change? Because it doesn't matter your size, you can still be a game changer. 100%. You got to be gentle in spirit and tough in taking the next step. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. So when it comes to how to be more attractive, you start where you left off. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Start where you left off. You can never get back the time of yesterday, but you can defend your time today in order to impact your tomorrow. That's why you got to start where you left off. And you know what that means, right? Moment by moment by moment. Presence is so important in our everyday. But most of us, we're living by habits. We're habitual creatures. It's easy to do that. But let me tell you, if you want a healthy lifestyle, Dr. Mark Hyman just had a new book release. I think it's Young Forever. It just came out yesterday. Great book. It gives you a plan. It tells you what to do to add years to your life. How many people do you think will read that book and then take the next step and actually do something for themselves? I would guess less than 5%. And in reality, closer to 2%. That is sad. Now, that's of the people who've actually bought the books, okay? I'm not talking about the entire world here. That's not what I'm talking about. Those people who actually picked up the books. There'll be some that will listen to the interviews. Now, I mention that not because he's a sponsor of this episode, because he's not. I mention it because we're always after the next big thing. We want that one magic pill. How many years did it take to get to where you are today? Good, bad, or ugly? Are you satisfied with where you are? Can you do better? It's all about becoming your best selfie, your best selfie. Not comparing yourself to me, not me comparing myself to you. It's who God has created you to be. You see, we're looking at the wrong reflections. It's called comparison. We look side to side. Instead of, oh, wait, up. Who does God want me to be? So when your presence is known in your everyday and you're showing up in the moment, that's when you start where you left off. So let's break that down. Number one, see the truth, not the lies. So much of what we want is entangled with lies. We make decisions that don't make sense to who we want to become, leaving only the answers to fulfill what we currently know. Think about that for a minute. We're taking these decisions that we know are not right for us, but we're comfortable with where we are, so we just continue making those same decisions. You can't change something that you're not willing to say, nope, that's a lie. I need to live out the truth. When you face the truth, that's where the transformation begins. Are you doing that? What area in your healthy lifestyle? I mean, if you could add on 10 years to your life, would you? No, seriously. I mean, that's an honest question here. My answer to that is yes. Now, I know I could go into some crazy tangent and say, oh, well, I don't know where the world's coming to and all of that. You know what? I put my faith in God and I pray that He is going to provide, and I take one step at a time and I know He's going to lead. What that looks like, I don't know, but I trust in that. And so with that trust How I walk by faith, 100% I would want to add 10 years on to my life. What about you? Some people actually would tell me no, and that's okay. But then I would have to ask why. Because to me, you're leaving behind something here on earth. Yes, if you're a believer, then you get to go and be in heaven with God. That's fabulous, right? That's eternity. But you know, I look at it here. Gosh, if I can see my grandchildren grow up and get married and maybe see a few of my great-grandchildren, do I want to be able to do that? Yes, 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 sign me up. But, and my big but is this, I want to do it on healthy terms. And that's where all of this gets me thinking, how to be more attractive. What can I do? It's not about how pretty I am. It's not about being the most beautiful. That has nothing to do with it, which I'm sure you thought, oh, where's Christiane going with this one today? It's about being the most attractive, meaning your best selfie, who God created you to be. So see the truth, not the lies. Number two, act on one thing, not lots of things. Don't overcomplicate your days. Life is complicated enough. So do what you can in the season you are in and create a rhythm. You're creating new patterns in your life. You need consistency to build resilience to your old habits. Did you hear me? You can't escape your old habits if you don't have resiliency. And that resiliency comes from consistency. It's a great equation. And it all comes from the acting on one thing. The one thing, not all things. See the truth. Act on one. And finally, number three, be who you are becoming, not the memories of your failures. You can knock yourself down as many times as you want, but the more you live like who you are becoming, the greater your chances of living the life you desire. You get to be who you want to be. And sometimes that's going to be hard. It's not always going to come easy. You're going to have to work at it. You're going to have to make tough choices. But when you're in the moment, it's a moment, not looking at the whole day. Because yeah, in 24 hours, you're going to be exhausted. If you look at your whole day, you're going to be exhausted. But if you look at, oh my gosh, I feel like there's a hunger coming over me. Well, am I really hungry? Okay, let's think about this. Well, I kind of am. My stomach's kind of telling me something, but you know what? I think I'm just thirsty. I think I'm going to take a drink of water. In fact, I'm going to go drink 8 ounces and see how I feel. And I'm going to let that sit for about 5 minutes. You go and do that. Okay, wait. Now let's rethink this. Am I really hungry? No, I'm not. I was just really thirsty. In fact, I'm going to drink some more water. And maybe it's been a long day already. It's midday. I want some tea. So I'm going to make myself some tea. That's a huge difference in saying, gosh, I'm hungry. And you go for a Snickers bar. And then you go and pop your favorite soda and delicious. Really? But your body says, oh, no, it's not. The cool thing is, yeah, you get to choose. But you get to choose moment by moment. So start where you left off. It's the next meal. It's the next hunger feeling. It's the next, gosh, I just kind of feel like I'm dragging day. Okay, maybe I need to go do some jumping jacks. Maybe I need to go walk around the block. Maybe I need to go to the park and just get some fresh air. Yeah, that may mean going out in the freezing cold and bundling up just so I can breathe fresh air for 15 minutes. If you're in the warmer part of the United States, man, there's some heat waves coming through. Some of it is record. We're about ready to hit that here for this time of year. Well, in that, go out and get some vitamin D. But you can't look at the whole day. You can look at it in generality to plan, but then take it moment by moment. If you're working in a corporate setting and you're like, gosh, I'm just inside all the time, then make time to go outside. Figure a way to eat something for a shorter period of time. So maybe it's a shake for you. You grab a smoothie, you make something real quick, and you go and you walk for the majority of your lunch break. That's going to benefit you a lot more than sitting down and having a cheeseburger, french fries, and a Coke to drink. Be who you are becoming. And yes, you can splurge once in a while, right? You can take the day off on your exercises, but don't do it for 3 weeks, which then becomes 3 months, which then leads to, yeah, you know what comes next, 3 years. Yeah, let's not go down that rabbit hole. But we're being realistic. It's hard to get to where you want to be, of who you want to see. But you can start where you left off. When it comes to being more attractive, it doesn't matter what others think. It doesn't. It matters who you see in your own reflection. Now, if you continue to cut yourself down and talk bad about yourself, that's where you're going to stay. That's just all there is to it. However, if you're willing to take a chance on transitioning to your goals, then that's where you'll find what you're looking for. So my challenge for you today, my friend, don't focus on all the stuff. Take what you can do today and do the best you can today. My prayer, may the peace of progress consume your soul as you work towards gaining the healthy lifestyle you desire, your goal. Go out, train for life. Love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.